It would be how much to charge. It would be how much to charge.
Right.
I feel like money is
Straight down to the money, the business end.
exactly. Money is such a sensitive topic, but everyone needs it, right? You need it to live. So yeah, it was how much they should charge. And the responses I've gotten from that, it's insane. People will just email me or, go in the comment section below and just write a message like, hey, I babysit in Arkansas and I charge like 7 an hour. Is that too little? Or currently I babysit for four children and the parents only pay me 20 a day, stuff like that. And I always tell them, I give them my honest 100%. Sometimes I either answer them directly or I personally shoot them an email. They shoot me an email, but I tell them, I'm like, hey, these are the five factors that you need to depend, your rate on, and don't ever go below that, especially if you're starting out and depending on your age too, because I feel like the younger you are, the more easier it is to take advantage. And that's something I don't want for my babysitters. So yeah, so just being raw and giving it my
Yeah.
100%.
I find that really interesting. I, having always had a professional sort of job and salary, talking about, and I guess it was sort of the way I was brought up, but you don't talk about income. You don't talk about what you earn because that's rude. That's not polite. But then I married into a family of artists, of actors and singers and stage people. And they openly talk about how much money they make. Like not in a crass way, like in my head, but they just talk about, oh, I made this much or they're offering this. And I would just sit there really awkward and think, oh, how can you have this conversation? And then my brother-in-law explained to me really clearly one day, he said, look, if we don't talk openly about it, we don't know if we're being ripped off. We don't know if we're getting the right rate. And so actors talk, singers and performers talk to each other, because if they don't do that, how do they know if they're in the right rate? And I think it comes from the fact that it's not standardized, it's not normal. And so what you just said then really resonated with me, because it's the same thing. There's not, I mean, there's like a minimum wage, but it's not always going to be done through the books. So, it needs someone like you to jump out there and say, hey, this is fair, this is right, this is what you should be asking for. And it gives, I guess it gives people that confidence to sort of either ask for more or think, actually, I'm on a pretty good deal here, so I'm going to stick with it. So I wonder if that's a trend that's true of a lot of different industries where, minimum wages or rate and salaries aren't published. So I find it quite intriguing that, that's the video that's worked for you, because I think it correlates well with theater and acting and probably a bunch of other industries where salaries aren't that well known. So yeah, it makes sense. And I guess the other thing too is it, again, it reaffirms you in that position of power, that position. I don't mean power in a negative way. I just mean like authority. You're in that position of authority and trust. So I can see that works really well for you.